and welcome to OT Over Easy. My name is Becca, and today we're going to do probably a pretty short video and a bit more of a casual video than I usually do, just to talk about wheelchair and seating cushions for a little bit. I hope to do a short series on wheelchairs for those of you who are preparing for an OT exam, but today we're going to kick that off just with the pretty simple topic of cushion choices. Different kinds of cushions and some keywords and buzz phrases to be looking out for when you're taking the exam or studying for the exam to cue you in to what answer they may be looking for when this sort of thing comes up in questions, okay? So when we're talking about cushions and seating, the purpose of a seating cushion is going to be wanting to consider reducing pressure on bony prominences, making sure pressure is as even as possible throughout a large surface area is how you're going to achieve that alleviation of pressure on the bony prominences. Excuse me. You may be wanting to consider, depending on your client, you may need to be considering postural control, the degree to which that they need support for that, and if they have some sort of physical deformity, your seating may need to accommodate that physical deformity or even try to reduce that physical deformity. There's two main kind of cushion shapes that you're going to want to be picking between: either a standard planar cushion, which is also just called a flat cushion. But if you see that word planar, don't be intimidated by it. It just means straight and flat. This is the kind of cushion that is going to be appropriate for someone who has good postural support. They're not going to need postural support for the cushion. They're more likely going to be just wanting the cushion for comfort. It's also going to be an appropriate cushion for someone who can reposition themselves independently, meaning they can do a little bit of a armchair push-up or something to shift around. If they're not able to do that at all by themselves in any way, chances are a planar or flat cushion is not going to be the best choice for them. So then the other choice is a contoured cushion, which can either be a standard contoured cushion just off the shelf, or a custom contoured cushion. So a contoured cushion as compared to a planar cushion is going to provide more support, and it's going to distribute pressure better because it's shaped either to that person or in such a way that is more ergonomic than a planar cushion. The downside is that it is going to be more expensive than a planar cushion for that reason, especially if you're getting a custom contoured cushion. Those price starts jumping really quickly as soon as you start making custom anything. The challenges with contour cushions as opposed to a flat or a planar cushion is that you are kind of limited by the cushion to maybe want just one position, and that can be particularly challenging for transfers. You know, if you've got a flat cushion, usually it's pretty easy to move around and on that cushion as needed to transfer, but if it's got weird lumps and bumps and tilts in it, that may be an extra hurdle to get over for transfers. And it's extra challenging in pediatrics because, like I said, custom, especially custom contoured cushions are very expensive, and they're unfortunately not going to grow with a child as the child grows. So costs can add up really quickly if you have to have a series of custom contoured cushions as a child grows out of their cushions. So that's a huge downside, is prices can be a big barrier for some people. So that's it for the main shapes. There's just planar and then contoured. So let's talk about the materials of the cushions. First, we've got foam. And the big buzzwords you're going to be looking out for in an exam question, if they want you to pick foam, are going to be cheap, and lightweight. Okay, so a foam cushion is the most common option for just general comfort, like someone just wants a little extra padding in their seat. If you work in especially like a skilled nursing facility or something, there's going to be tons and tons of just standard flat foam cushions to be found everywhere, because more often than not, people who are using wheelchairs are going to want one just to stick in their wheelchair for a little extra comfort. The problems or the challenges with foam cushions is that they have poor durability, right? They're not super, their longevity isn't great. And also they don't have very even pressure relief, because if you think about foam, again, it's going to depend on the density of the foam, but sometimes you might just sink right into it, so you're basically sitting on the chair and it's not providing that much support, or it could be really firm and you're not sinking into it at all, in which case that's also not providing great pressure relief either. So foam, mostly a comfort thing, rather than a pressure relief or support thing. But your keywords for foam are going to be lightweight and cheap, because of all the options that I'm going to talk about, unless you're getting custom contoured ones, foam is almost certainly going to be the least expensive and the lightest of any of the options. So next, let's talk about a gel-filled cushion. So a gel-filled cushion, your keyword here for an exam question is going to be good postural stability. Gel-filled cushions are going to be one of the best options for providing a real good base of support. They also are going to provide better pressure relief than a foam cushion is going to. The downside of a gel cushion is that they are heavy. They're very, very heavy. So if your exam question indicates that the cushion cannot be heavy, then gel is probably not what they want. The other thing is that they're a little bit temperature sensitive and they can leak. Those are other considerations. But if your question is really honing on they want really good postural stability, they're probably asking for a gel-filled cushion. Next up, we've got an air-filled cushion. Now, an air-filled cushion is kind of the flip side of the gel-filled cushion in that it has absolutely terrible postural support. I mean, if you think about sitting on like an exercise ball or something, you're kind of wibbling wobbling all over the place, right? But it is great for pressure distribution. If your exam question is emphasizing even distribution of pressure, air is where it's at. That is what an air cushion is best for. Obviously, it's going to be pretty lightweight as well. So that is an advantage over the gel cushion, because it's just filled with air. What is lighter than air? So it is lightweight, great for pressure relief, but you still have this leaking problem as well, right? Like with any ball or balloon, if it gets a puncture, it's not going to work anymore. So that is a disadvantage and something you need to consider. Next up is the honeycomb cushion, which is sort of an in-between of the gel and the air-filled cushions. It's not going to give as good a pressure relief as an air cushion, and it's not going to provide as good a stable base of support as a gel-filled cushion, but it is more lightweight than a gel cushion. It is more stable than an air-filled cushion. It's easier to clean, so it's sort of like an in-between between the two. Something that is good to know, though, is that they can be really thick often to get that honeycomb structure and to have it be stable enough to be effective. They can be really thick, which sometimes isn't a problem, sometimes it is. So it's just something to be aware of. You can also get hybrid cushions, which are different combinations of these different materials layered with each other. Obviously, the pros and cons of each hybrid cushion is going to depend on what kind of materials are in there. So you can have any number of combinations. So I think it's less likely that an exam question is going to ask you for that, but I think you should just be aware that hybrid cushions do exist. And then finally, this is not a material cushion, but rather a style of cushion that I think is still important for someone who's getting ready to take an exam should know, and it is an alternating pressure cushion. This is a cushion that is mechanical, automatic, will provide inflation and deflation on some sort of schedule in order to provide changes in pressure, as the name would suggest. This is a really, really great option for somebody who is not able to reposition themselves and they are not able to have somebody with them to help them reposition when they need to. Just so you guys know, generally it's recommended that people who are in a seated position have some sort of repositioning or pressure relief every 15 to 30 minutes, whether that is doing a little bit of an armchair push-up like so. It can be leaning either to the side or front to back. It can be tilting in space if you have a tilt in space chair, or it can be an alternating pressure cushion if none of those options are available to you. So it is an option that exists, but the main barrier to this is going to be cost. Alternating pressure cushions are unfortunately very expensive, so they are a fantastic tool, but unfortunately come at a pretty significant cost. So that is not a viable option for a lot of people for that reason. So that's it for this one. As with any topic I cover in any of my videos, there is a lot more meat to these topics and a lot more detail that you could go into, but I think in terms of studying for a generalist exam, this is pretty much all you need to know. If you start going more into details, you're just going to be bogging down yourself and you're going to start freaking yourself out because you can't remember it all. So I would just let it go. Remember big picture stuff. I think if you know the key points that I have presented in this video, you should be able to get through a generalist OT exam just fine with regards to this topic. As always, I've got a list of the resources that I'm pulling information from in the description below if you do want to read further into these topics. And I hope to make a couple more videos on wheelchairs coming up in the future. But until then, happy studying.